Hello, fellow scripters. Welcome to another episode of Learn More JavaScript on the ServiceNow platform. Today, we are learning about JavaScript's date and time objects. Managing dates and time is a common task in programming, and JavaScript provides us with a date object to make it easy. So let's not waste another second and dive right in. The JavaScript date object represents a moment in time. It can be used to get the current date and time, perform some date manipulations, and convert dates and times to a string. Remember, the date object always stores dates in UTC time and displays them in the local time zone of the browser or server. That's a fun little background fact for it. So let's see what kind of cool things we could do with the date and time object. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new date object. And then let's start playing around with it. I can find out the current date and time. Let's say current date and time by just simply calling it. So let's see what happens when I run that. And now, like I said, it stores it as UTC, but my browser is in Pacific time. So it displays it as Wednesday, November 22nd, 2023 at 12:48. Is it really 12:48? Man, I need to eat lunch. And displays it in my time zone. The other things we could do with it is stuff like, let's say, what is the year? The year is now. So what we've stored date inside now. So we can say now.getFullYear. We could say the month is same, similar way. Oops, let me put a plus sign there. Now.getMonth. And we could say the day is now.getDate. Let's run this script. You'll see the year is 2023. The month is 10. We'll come back to that. And the day is 22. So as of the recording of this video, it is November 22nd, 2023. And so the month is off. And why is that? And that's because months are zero indexed inside of this object. So if you want to display it properly, you have to always make sure to go right here and make sure you say plus one. And okay, now I'll show the gotcha here too. So I'll run the script and it's going to say 10, 1, 101. We got to remember to take that part of the code and put it in its own parentheses so that it treats it as integers instead of strings. There you go. Now it's proper. Now, if I wanted to say the year, month, and day, I can do it with the date object inside JavaScript. So there's that. Other things that we could do, we can also set specific parts of the date. So let's try that right now. We'll get now set full year. Let's set it to 2020 instead. And then let's see what happens with that year inside of the function. Changed year, and now get full year. And let's run that. You can see the original one says 2023 because when we created that date object, it instantiated based off of what it is currently, which is for me 2023. But then I set it to 2020 and then called it again. And now you can see it thinks it's 2020. And finally, the last thing I wanted to show you can do with this is take that local date string and convert it to readable strings. So if I say local date string and now to local date string and call it, you could see it made it prettier. November 22nd, 2020. It still retained that new date of the year that I set, but it's a much more readable format. To look up the other ways you can play with the date object and all the different methods that are available to you within the date object, I honestly will search for it on internet. If I'm looking for a specific use case or a specific method that might be helpful to me. Otherwise, here are a few of the more common ones. Thanks.